to a brand new episode of Coming Distractions, brought to you by the Nerdpocalypse podcast. I'm your host, Jay. I'm here with my co-host, Deacon.
Hey.
All right, guys, we're back. This time we're going to talk about the newly released film, The Photograph, starring Issa Rae and Lakeith Stanfield. Deacon, you had a chance to see this movie. So tell us what the premise is and your thoughts.
All right, so you have a situation with two characters that meet by kind of unusual circumstances, but they don't know it's unusual just yet. Okay. It kind of is really nothing special to how they meet, but it's the basic romantic comedy of boy meets girl, and we go through that journey.
Wait, is it a romantic comedy or?
That's what I was about to get to, though.
Okay.
So I saw a few of the news outlets saying it's kind of romantic comedy drama.
Okay,
it's not a romantic comedy at all. It's a romantic drama.
Okay.
It definitely has bits of comedy elements in there, but it's not a comedy.
I imagine they're tagging it that way just because Issa Rae. Because she does, you know, she has like comedic elements like to her shows and stuff.
Right. Yeah. So, but it's definitely not romantic comedy. So,
okay.
Get out of the way. So, what you want to know?
All right. So they meet. And so, tell us about that. Like, is it just sort of one of the, is it a run of the mill thing? I mean, people are equating this to being more in the style of like the sort of 90s black romance films. Like, is it more in that realm, or where does it sit for you?
You can definitely tell. Well, first and foremost, let me just get this out the way. It is a good film.
Okay.
It's a good movie. Not great. Definitely not terrible. Okay. Definitely not terrible. It's a good movie. And kind of going back to what you just asked me about, you can tell that the director and the writer were heavily, heavily influenced by Love Jones.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
But take that with a grain of salt, because that does not mean they lean on that. Okay. They still carve their own path and have a completely different story that's being told.
Okay, good.
Yeah,
but I mean, Love Jones is considered one of the top line
right.
of that era. So yeah, that makes sense. How were the performances?
Performances were decent.
Yeah.
I think a lot of it is maybe due to the writing, where they may fall short, because they'll hit maybe two or three spots where it's like, okay, they're rolling.
Yeah.
But then they may fall short elsewhere. So some of the writing is a little clunky. Even the way Lakeith and Issa kind of get together, you don't immediately feel that chemistry.
Okay.
So it's kind of a work in progress. excuse me. Lakeith is good. He's just Lakeith. He has his awkward, cool, suave, black thing down.
And it's cool because he's all over the place at this
point.
And I don't mean that as a negative. I mean, like, he is doing roles that are just in a little bit of everything. So, yeah, I actually really appreciate where his career is going.
Everybody else as a whole was good, did pretty good, especially, of course, I don't know neither one of their names. The actors that played Isaac. Who is
Ilan Noel?
Yeah, because
or Ilan Noel. Yeah, he's the dude from he was on Insecure and the First Purge.
Right? Yeah, and
so she's worked with him.
And before. the older actor that plays Isaac, that was like a great casting.
Rob Morgan, apparently.
Yeah, you can clearly.
Oh yeah, the guy played Turk from Daredevil.
You can definitely see. Yeah, that could be the younger version or older versions of each other.
Okay, cool.
So back to some of the acting too with Issa. She's getting better, but you can definitely still tell she's kind of trying to figure out her niche.
Yeah.
So that's maybe like sometimes with some of their scenes and some of the dialogue where it may have fell short a couple times, but to kind of give Issa some props, man. Like, some people like just need to be on a movie screen.
Yeah.
I don't want to curse, excuse me. But yeah, seriously, like, she really,
no,
like,
she's beautiful.
She holds your attention when you watch her on screen. And her and Lakeith have a great visual chemistry, even though the chemistry like wasn't working off the top, but you saw them together.
Yeah,
it's a good look, especially to kind of be like on the nose, hit it on the nose. Two dark skin.
Yeah, I was gonna say
actors, leads in this movie. Yeah, it's dope.
Yeah, like, I mean, that was a point I was actually gonna ask you about. Like, it is nice to see there is like Lil Rel Howery is in this as well. Like, it's cool to see, like, this is that new section of Black Hollywood.
Right.
Like, this sort of modern version, and that's kind of cool. And then like Courtney B. Vance is in it and stuff like that. So
and Rel did pretty good too. I enjoyed all his scenes.
I think that dude is really quite.
Yeah,
funny.
Like he didn't do too much. He did just enough for what they needed for that moment.
Yeah.
But also too, what I think for me, I mean, maybe some people may feel like this when they see it. Even though I did like the story with Lakeith and Issa, the backstory with her mother and her father, I could watch a movie on that.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, especially with the chemistry that those two actors had going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah,
it's a good look.
So what's your out of 5 score for the photograph?
Oh, man, I will give it... You know what? I'm going to give it 4 solid patchouli yours.
All right, yeah. It's a little bit of a hippie vibe.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Maybe some sandalwood in there, but you know.
There you go. All right, so 4 out of 5 for the photograph, and we will see you guys next time.
Yep.
Bye. Peace. You're watching the Nerdpocalypse YouTube channel. Make sure you click that button to subscribe and check out our weekly podcast where we talk about movie, TV, news, tech, and weird stories from around the internet.